G'day, my name is Ji Deeg, and I am a sound engineer. I am a recording artist. I play in the band Kabashi, and most recently, I've become an NDIS support worker. I'd like to tell a little story about one of the guys that I've been working with recently by the name of Nick Walker. I was introduced to Nick Walker through my place of employment, which is Casson Homes. I was filled in about Nick, how Nick has had a few learning difficulties growing up, as he has over the years. Because of some of these, he is on NDIS, and he really sort of would like to get himself out there. Now, I said to him, what do you like? What are you into? What makes you happy? And he said he loves hip-hop music. And I asked him, well, have you ever written music? Have you ever tried, you know, to write your own songs? He said, oh, I'd love to, but, you know, I'm not really sure how to go about it. And we were really lucky because it's something that I've had a lot of experience in over the years. As I've been doing of REN youth centres, where music is a massive part of what we do, and I was lucky enough to say, well, I've got friends in the industry, I've got a professional recording studio, and we were lucky enough to be able to, you know, like lay down some tracks and just give Nick a taste of what you can and can't do, obviously, with recording. Now, he, one, was really excited, and two, I'm gonna say it changed Nick as a human being. He's now so much more outgoing, willing to engage with people because of this process. So, you know, we started by like looking at lyrics and looking at artists that we both, you know, like recognize were, you know, singing about situations that may be similar to what Nick has gone through in his life. We looked at artists that he likes and the way that, as he says, the way the music flows. Then we put together some lyrics and we asked, well, what do you want to sing about? And he goes, I'd love to tell the story of my life and what I do, and, you know, that there's hope and that I can possibly make it and you know, and possibly one day record my own song. So as part of my job, which was spending time and supporting Nick in his day-to-day life, it was also really good to provide an opportunity for Nick to grow and for Nick to also have a go at something that he really likes and just to lift his spirits and just to, you know, like for some people that just never really get the opportunity to do the things they would always like to do. And I had the ability to be able to provide that.
So I'm Nicholas Walker, I'm from Clarkston. I used to live in Wanneroo with my dad as well.
Mate, how long have you been interested in hip-hop music?
Since I was probably little, I've always had a passion for it. Even one of my cousins, he's up there, so I've gained a lot of respect for him for doing it.
Can you tell us a bit about your cousin? Who is he and where he's from and what he does as far as hip-hop goes?
His name's called Diabetic, but he's up there with a lot of the other main artists that I've seen, and his music is awesome. It is kind of, it inspired me to kind of enjoy it more and just get more confidence out of it.
Why you're on NDIS if you can? And tell us like what difficulties you face that other people probably don't in this world.
So I'm on learner difficulty because I was in an ed support group as well at school, and I struggled a lot with learning and just trying to get around the world, like trying to learn where I'm doing right and wrong in the world. Yeah, just my mental, just struggling with daily living and all that stuff as well.
Do you find it hard, like, is it concentration is difficult to really hone in and concentrate on something for long periods of time?
Yes, it's difficult because I get distracted really quick, and it's, even doing very long, subjects or doing anything makes it harder for me as well to kind of focus on what I've got to do.
To see Nicholas when he first walked into the studio to the man he is today, which is confident. He's, as I said, willing to engage, would like to sit there and talk to you. He's just become a great young man, and he has changed. He's become way more confident. I think he feels he has identity, and he feels that he belongs in the community. And, you know, now it's not, hi, my name is Nicholas. I'm on the NDIS. It's now, hi, I'm Nicholas, hip hop artist.
So Robin's my recovery coach. She's been helping me with the nitty gritty, kind of getting me to places, making sure that I'm doing all the stuff I need to do. Jar's been helping me out with my music, he's a support worker, but he's been helping me out with from counseling and all that stuff. He's been helping me with the supports of getting me to the next step and all that stuff. Mum's seen a lot of the depression, the anxiety, all the stresses in my life since I was little and all that stuff as well. It's helping me a lot better because I don't have to worry about using other ways to kind of think. There's so many different ways to fix myself. And listening to music or doing something different than using other ways of drugs or trying to help other people out would be the best part that I need to do. But I used to have really bad anger issues. I couldn't really control myself, and I would go spirals around a lot with my emotions as well.
Yeah. Does this give you an option to channel your emotions into something positive?
Sure does. Sure does. It helps out a lot more. Just keep your head up, try your hardest. Even though if life doesn't give you the way you need to go, just there's always ways to kind of escape from that pain that you need to be in.
So that's kind of the message that you're giving.
Yeah.
But how would, by finding that passion, how does it help?
It gives you a big positive. It changes the way that you think of life as well. Yeah, it's changed my personality a lot. It made me feel a lot better about myself and finding my next step in life. Yeah, I feel like doing this song is just... It was stressful, but it also was really good to kind of see everything come into place and make sure the video was great. Even the lyrics, it was hard to get a lot of the lyrics done and writing them again perfectly, but we finally got it done and I was happy how far it got.
Can you tell me how you went about writing the song? Can you take us through the steps? So how did it sort of come together? Was it something that I suggested or perhaps you suggested? And just take us through roughly the steps from what you can remember as to how it all happened.
So it was pretty much just myself. I've kind of gone through a really deep stage with my previous relationship. And it was just kind of express what I've been going through. And it was very difficult to kind of find out where I wanted to be in life. So I wrote that to kind of make sure that I can find a better way to kind of change what's going on with my life instead of thinking there's always this dark, there's no way of going forward. So even with a lot of the lyrics, I wanted to all match up together so it could actually mean something when I dropped the video.
Did you start off by writing lyrics?
Yeah, I started by writing lyrics.
And what was it? You kind of just said it then, but what was it that you wrote about that...
It was pretty much just struggles with my previous partner and just trying to find where I need to be in this world and all that stuff and find my personality.
And then how did you find the beats? What did you use? So we used ProLogic?
We used ProLogic and they had a lot of different beats on there, so we just kept going through to find what would match with the song and make sure that the lyrics were connected together and all that stuff as well.
Yeah, brilliant. When it came to shooting the video, what were you expecting in the video? What do you know? Did you have something in your head before shooting the video as to what you kind of wanted?
No, not really. But it was very, like, how the video turned out really amazing.
Is it strange seeing yourself back being on that video?
Oh, it's very strange, but... It's sort of also like a relief and somewhat like to actually realize that I actually dropped myself my first song, which usually takes a lot of people to do that for a very long time to get into doing that, writing a song, then dropping videos and dropping a video clip at the same time. It's pretty crazy.
What do you think? Do you think organizations could probably learn a lot from this and maybe do it with more people? As far as, do you think that this would benefit people who are on NDIS to do this kind of thing?
Yeah, I reckon it probably could. All you have to do is just try and talk it out and find a way that you can do it. Because it's also about your own personal control as well.
Yeah. And do you feel you've grown in confidence since making this video?
Oh, a lot more. A lot more.
Do you sort of call yourself like a hip-hop artist now?
Yeah, sure do.
If you have the chance to make another video and another song, is it something you really want to do?
Oh, sure. I would love to do another video again. Just sort of try and find the next beat, find out what next I've got to write down and all that stuff. Just pretty much self-care as well would be a big thing as well. Just making sure that you can get out there in the hard stages, you know?
Yeah. Do you think that there's a chance that this video will take you back and remind you of a good part of your life and make things better?
Yeah, I sure will. Yeah, which it will probably make it a lot better than realizing lashing out and stuff that I can't do and can't fix. It would be good for people to kind of express what's going on with their lives instead of always bordering their lives up, because it's hard. It's difficult to kind of show your emotions as well.
Where do you see yourself in 5 years' time?
Up there, doing good, with a lot of money, making sure that I've got the right plan to go forward.
Do you think you can do that on your own, or would it be good to have someone help along?
It would be good to also have someone along, but also be able to do it by myself at some stage.
Thanks, Nick. So, if you get the chance, take a look at what he's done. And I'd just like to say that this is what NDIS and what we at CASN would like to bring, obviously, to the people that we work with, is, you know, providing sort of platforms and pathways and steps to, one, reaching potential, but two, just realizing that, you know, some goals are very achievable and small things can make big differences. And this is Nick Walker, and here's his song called Dark Path.
Did you ever want to go one place and the gang wanted to go somewhere else? What did you do? How pleasant was your personality?
I've been trying to escape from all the problems, but they're still there when I wake up. Sometimes I just feel nothing. It's the way it is, cause life is tough. What is going on and messing me up? Right to my core, deep inside. I've done it all by myself, with no help. I thought I needed you, but you lied. I'm still the same person, but I got used. Now I'm broken with an ice cold heart. I'm turned into someone that I don't like, that doesn't know the end from the start. If you're my enemy, you're not worth battling. This ain't gonna help with mental health. Every day I try to be a better person, try and make a change for myself. When I'm going through the hardest stages, smoking weed gets rid of the pain. Now because of the blame that people put on me, so what exactly are you trying to gain? Don't explain why you left me in the first place. You know nothing is going to change. These feelings I'm feeling are normal. It's not informal, but coming from you is strange. Sometimes like walking down a dark path, wait for the aftermath, bury the rage. I am the Prime Minister, time to administer something sinister, turn the page.
What do we mean when we talk about personality? What is your personality? It is the way you get along with other people around you and with your changing environment. You want certain things from other people and from environment. The way to go about getting those things reveals your personality.
Now I try to move on to the next chapter. I try to stay afloat with my head held high. I'm tired of the head noises, I'm running at you. I grab wings and learn to fly. Time to let the strife from the past life. I can call on the pain to make me strong. Time to grow and channel my energy into rhymes on time on a hip-hop song. stay ugly.